Hello and welcome to the Anti-Size channel. My name is Christian Gollwitzer and I'm going to show you in this video how we do sucks measurements at the PTB. The PTB is the National Metrology Institute of Germany. Our basic task is to reproduce the basic SI units like the meter and the kilogram, but also to perform traceable measurements of all kinds. In this picture, you see the synchrotron radiation facility BESI 2. It's located in Berlin Adlershof and operated by the Helmholtz Zentrum. And one division of PTB has a lab inside this building where we can do sucks measurements. Here you see the basic principle of a sucks measurement. An X-ray beam hits the sample, which is usually enclosed in a small glass tube, and most of the light just goes straight through the sample or is absorbed in the sample. But a tiny fraction of radiation is scattered under small angles, typically 1 degree and less, and then collected onto a two-dimensional detector. If you want to learn more about sucks in general, please check out the other videos in this channel. At the PTB, we use the synchrotron light from a bending magnet of BESI 2 as the X-ray source. The synchrotron light covers a wide energy range from the infrared over visible and UV light up to X-rays. At the FCM beamline, we can use X-rays in a range from 1.75 up to 10 kV. The synchrotron light is passed and collimated through a set of slits and focused using focusing mirrors onto the sample. The monochromator, which is located here, selects an energy within this range with an uncertainty of 10 to the minus 4. The scattered light from the sample then passes into the sucks setup of the Helmholtz Zentrum. Here you can see a picture of the whole setup. The sample chamber is located over here, and the scattered radiation from the sample then goes into the sucks machine with a long vacuum tube here. At the end of the sucks machine, we have attached a Pilatus detector with 1 megapixels to collect the scattered radiation. The whole path between the detector, the sample, and also until the storage ring is evacuated, because also air scatters the X-rays, and we do want to reduce this background. Using the sucks machine, we can continuously change the distance between the detector and the sample without breaking the vacuum, and also adjust the beam path with the detector movement. The samples for a sucks measurement are usually liquid dispersions, and they need to be prepared and closed in a container in order to be measured in the vacuum. Here you see my colleague Jerome Däumer, who prepares a sample for sucks measurements. First, the ampoule is opened. Then he picks out a single capillary from the package. This must be done very carefully, because the glass of the capillary is only 10 micrometers thick. Then a small volume of the sample is drawn out of the ampoule with a disposable syringe. The sample is carefully injected into the capillary. The whole volume required to fill the capillary is only 20 microliters. This is only a small droplet. The capillary is then closed by welding in the flame of a propane oxygen torch. The torch is extremely hot. It has a temperature of 2800 degrees Celsius. This allows us to melt the glass and tightly enclose the sample so that it can be put into the vacuum without evaporating the sample. These capillaries are then stored in a holder together with standard samples which are used to calibrate the instrument. This holder is then transferred into the sample chamber with the help of a vacuum lock. After closing the lock, the air is pumped out and the sample is moved to the X-ray beam. Our measurement software allows us to set up an arbitrary sequence of measurements for many different samples. When the experiment is done, the data needs to be evaluated. First, we select the correct measurement, in this case the NP-size 10 sample. The two-dimensional scattering pattern is then transformed into the one-dimensional scattering curve. This is also called the data reduction step. Then the scattering curve is loaded into the program for SUCS data analysis. First, we select the model for spherical particles and then we start the fitting. This gives us the particle diameter. This analysis is explained in more detail in the video about traceability. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and don't forget to check out the other videos in this channel.